If you want to create your very own first game but have a hard time deciding how and where to start, or if you have already published a game and simply need the motivation to continue and start over a new project, this video is exactly for you. Make sure to stay till the end and hopefully you will find all the answers you need for the one and only question: how to make your first game and publish it. I am Savu, your game devil, and if you are new to the channel, consider subscribing for more game development content like this. So you have been playing some games, played some more, and then it hit you. What if I could make my dream game on my own? What if I can make the next big hit with tons of players? Whoa, slow down a bit, sir. You see, this kind of thinking brings us to the first point: shrink down on expectations. It is your first game after all, and your focus should be in completing simple and small tasks one at a time. Don't jump in front of your PC thinking that you will create the next Fortnite, because it's almost certain you won't. Not because you don't have the right skills and ideas that will help you in achieving this, but simply because it's your first game. Try to think about a game that you could complete in 2 to 4 weeks. Even that game will take you a couple of weeks longer than you have planned, but it's okay. Game development is a journey that you need to enjoy and learn from it. Your main and most important goal should be to have a playable product at the end of your deadline. What I mean with playable: keep it simple and remember that for your first game you don't want something perfect, you want something that can be played and most importantly something that you are proud of. Take Flappy Bird as an example. It has no storytelling, simple graphics, one mechanic with easy controls and very beginner friendly coding requirements. All in all, a playable game that you can enjoy and make in a short period of time. Of course, we all have different skills and are good or not so good in something. This brings us to point number 2. Focus around skills that you are already good at. Let's say you have enough experience in coding, but your drawing skills need some more practice. Don't get overwhelmed and think that your game will be in the shadow of a AAA game. No, you can create something very unique and create a whole world with its own story, using just some basic shapes and drawings. The possibilities are endless, but if you think that your game still needs this extra kick, then you can look for open source assets, sprites, music, 3D models, and anything you can think of. Very talented people around the world are actually kind enough to share their work for free to use in your project. And with that said, point number 3. Don't be afraid of using assets that you didn't create. I made this mistake for a long time and I thought that my game should also consist of only my assets. That was silly and I can only suggest you to look for free open source assets, or if you have a friend that can help you out, even better. By doing this, you can cut down on the production time of your game and focus on other aspects of it rather than trying to draw the perfect UI start button that the player sees for a couple of seconds in only the first scene of your game, although it's still important. Choose a game engine. There are a lot of awesome game engines out there, each different but with huge potential, giving you the chance of creating whatever you have on your mind. Eventually you will adapt to it and it's really just a matter of personal preference. Since it will be your first game though, look for an engine that also provides a lot of learning content like documentaries, videos, tutorials and a community of helpful people. The Unity logo is just random here and has absolutely nothing to do with the fact that my channel is full of Unity tutorials that you can watch and follow along while creating your first game. But it will bring us to the next point: watch tutorials. YouTube is where I started learning game development, and even now I still search for something that I need or want to learn here on YouTube. Tutorials are great and there are thousands available. You don't know how to create a game character? Click here. What? You need to implement a health system? Here you go. Oh, you need a sprite sheet? You get the point. The best part of this is that you have access to all the knowledge you need in creating your very first game for free. So watch tutorials and take your time until you have a better knowledge and idea about the concept of game development. Finish your game and let people play. After some hard weeks, you finished your game. You had some ups and downs, got tired, then got motivated again, but you finally managed to have a playable game in your hands. This is already a huge achievement and you can be proud of yourself for completing it. Well done, developer! The next step here is to be confident enough to get real feedback from players who will test and play your game. I know this might seem scary, but it's the only way to understand what went wrong, what went right, and what you need to change in order to provide a better gameplay experience. Strangers and people who have never seen your project before see the game differently than you. This is because you know every little detail about it. You worked on it since the day one and it was in front of you every day since then. It's very easy to lose track and the whole picture sometimes. Let's start small and give your game to your family and friends to watch them play and see their reactions. There is nothing better than getting real-time feedback and suggestions for your game. If you want to go a step further, you can also find online communities like Facebook groups or Discord servers with people who want to try and play new games while providing the feedback you need. As you create more and more games, this process will be easier and easier to manage, and you will want to find testers as soon as possible. At that point, you are ready for number 7. Prepare your audience and publish. Congratulations, you have made your first game and are ready to hit the market. Easier said than done. Don't expect people to just find your game and explode your downloads, since marketing is another crucial part in succeeding. Make people know about your game and raise the anticipation for your release date. If you are on a budget, or you are a student and game dev is currently just a side hobby, then there are still some free methods you should definitely try out. First of all, create a small trailer for your game, about 1 to 2 minutes long, with all the important parts for the gameplay that make it stand out. There are a lot of free editing tools that you can use and learn in no time. Now with the trailer ready, you want to show it off, of course, and what's a better place than social media? Post it wherever you can. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Reddit, even TikTok is a great place for exposure. To have even more content, you can also take screenshots or create GIFs from your game that you can also share. Finally, but a little bit more time consuming, is the email method. Find websites and forums about new indie games and try to approach them by sending a nice email with a detailed explanation about your game. Every game has a chance to be featured somewhere, and don't forget that these websites also search for new games. I mean, that's what they need to stay relevant. And by the way, relevant, if you want to continue your game dev journey, point 8 is for you. Your next game will be better than the one before. Start to work on your next project as soon as possible. Try to improve on new things and build on skills you learned from your previous game. You still don't want to shoot for perfection though. It will come on its own as you progress and create more and more games. Remember, the experience counts more than the final product and be proud of all your creations. With every game you create, you climb up the next step of the ladder that represents your game development journey. I really hope you found some valuable and useful tips in this video, and if you're just starting out, let me know in the comments below. I would love to see the game dev community grow, with new developers joining us every day. With that said, thank you so much for watching till the end. If you liked the video, gently tap the like button, and I'll see you next time. Keep developing. Ciao!